If you are tired of feeling impatient, discouraged, and overwhelmed during your Spanish language learning journey, and you'd prefer to feel a little something like this.
Erica, I did it. Thank you so much for giving me this. This is so exciting.
You are in the right place. Today, you'll discover what had my client, Johanna, so excited about her Spanish and the number one thing that you need to be doing to maintain motivation on this marathon that is language learning. Comencemos, amigos. What's up, language leaders? Welcome back to another video. My name is Erica, here to help you learn, love, and live the Spanish language. If you have not yet done so, or if you are new around here, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so that you do not miss any future videos. Now, before we get going, I want to give you a free gift. This is my language routine audit checklist. It's a super simple document, but very powerful if you apply it. It's designed so that you can take a careful look at your own language learning routine and find those critical areas that may not be optimized or that may be missing entirely from your routine and tweak those areas so that you can make sure that you're learning your language in the most efficient and effective way possible. You can find that at the link below. Now, I want to take a moment to talk to you about human tendencies. So assuming that you are a human watching this video, this will very likely apply to you. So in order to do this, I actually want to step a bit outside of the language learning arena and into another interest of mine in life, which is personal finance. Now, a few years ago, when my husband and I decided to become completely debt-free and eliminate all student loans, credit cards, all of that, I researched a lot of financial gurus and advice just to see how we could do this as easy as possible. Because the fact was, we had set this goal in the past and still had not accomplished it. So I knew there had to be a better way. So I came across all of this financial advice, and among the gurus, of course, if you're into finance, you know Dave Ramsey. So Dave Ramsey taught me about this concept of the debt snowball. So if you're not familiar with the debt snowball, this is when you order your debts from smallest to greatest, and you get laser focused on eliminating the smallest one first. And you do this completely disregarding the interest rate. You're not concerned about which one has the highest interest rate. You just order your debts smallest to largest and pay them off in that order. This results in the feeling of satisfaction and quick wins. And because of that, you're more motivated to keep going and completely eliminate all of your debts. So while you're laser focused on just one of your debts, whichever is the smallest in that moment, you're of course making minimum payments on all of them in order not to fall behind. But all of your extra money is going just towards this one smallest debt so that you can knock it out as soon as possible. Again, you do it this way in spite of the fact that on paper, it makes the most mathematical sense to in fact pay off your debts with the highest interest rate first. But that's not how you do it in the debt snowball. The fact is, we are not robots, we are humans, and a lot of the things that we do or that we're able to continue to do once we start them are based on emotion, they're based on how we feel, and our motivation level is critical in order for us to be able to complete anything in life. By the way, it worked, in case you were wondering. We've been completely debt-free for quite a while now. After other methods had failed for us, the debt snowball was a simple, stress-free way and motivational way to get it all done. Language learning, for most of us, works in a very similar way. it may make the most logical sense to memorize the 100 most common Spanish words, or the 1,000 most commonly used Spanish words, or to understand completely how we conjugate all of the verbs in the regular tenses, and a whole bunch of other seemingly logical, but honestly, non-human way of doing things. And traditionally, this is exactly the way that language has been taught. Vocabulary list, grammar drills, and that kind of thing. And you know what? It really hasn't worked, because we are people and we need to see a result, a very tangible result that's not too far off into the future, so that we can see our progress, stay motivated, and not worry so much about that final finish line. Is there even a final finish line in language learning? I don't think that there is. Now, Yahana, who you saw briefly at the beginning of this video, is one of my clients in the Fluency Accelerator program. So in my program, we start with setting very specific goals and putting time frames to those goals. Now, Yahana was coming to me with almost zero prior experience with Spanish, and she has big goals for her Spanish, which the way she's going, I am certain she is going to be able to accomplish all of them. But along the way, as we work together, we set very specific and smaller goals that she could get done right away. So she told me that one of the things that she would love to be able to do would be to go to her local refresqueria, which is a local shop that sells drinks, fresh drinks, fruit drinks, vegetable and fruit snacks, and has Spanish-speaking owners. So she wanted to be able to go in there, greet the owners, order what she wanted. She wanted to have, you know, some extra vocabulary there in the background, because, hey, she may not be ordering the same thing every time, right? So she wanted to be comfortable with all of those options that they had available that she really likes, be able to order, pay, thank them, and that was it. So we started right there. And this is the video that she surprised me with after one of our sessions.
Erica, I did it. I did it. I just left on my way back to the cafe and I went to the refresqueria. And I was like, you know what? Today is the day. I am going by and I'm doing this. And I did it. I used my conversation. I got my vaso con mango y pepino with cocoa. I said, quiero que sea picante. I got my large agua fresca de coco. Girl, I did it all. And when I first walked in, the owner, she just said hi. And then I said hola, and I went on into my Spanish. And she was so gracious, and she didn't ask me if I was learning. She just answered. Yeah! I did it. Thank you so much for giving me this. This is so exciting.
I smile every time I watch that. Yahana, you made my entire week by sending me that. Thank you. Now, this goal may seem small, but look at the effect that it had on her. And now she is all ready and pumped for her next goal, which is more complex, and she's already doing amazing with it. In language learning, there are a lot of things that we are working on at the same time. Listening, reading, writing, speaking, pronunciation, vocabulary, grammar. And when our routine is really well put together and very efficient, we can work on all of those things at the same time. But we want to always have one tangible goal that is not too far off in the future, where we're really putting our focus so that we can actually accomplish it, check it off our list, and then transfer our skills over into that next goal. So I encourage you to do something very similar. Why not think about big picture, what you want to accomplish, break it down into smaller goals, order them from smallest to largest if you would like, and put a large portion of your energy towards accomplishing your first goal. After that, do not forget to celebrate your win once you have accomplished it. Guys, I love to hear about your wins. I want to celebrate with you. I love it when you guys send me emails and DMs and pictures and all kinds of things about what you're doing with your language. Please continue to do so. During the next couple of weeks, I actually have a special way for you to submit those wins to me, and I will leave all of that information in the description below. Now, having a goal-based routine is only part of the equation, so make sure you do grab your copy of my language routine audit so that you can see if there are any other areas in which you could improve in your own routine. Again, you can find that link in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video, well, don't leave without telling me. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe, hit that bell, and most importantly, don't forget to go out and live a new language today. I will see you next time.